Hi, everyone, and welcome to the preview show delivered by FedEx. I'm Marty Snider from NBC Sports. This is Chris Rice from College Racing, also right here at NASCAR.com. Brad Keselowski wins the first playoff race. I tell you what, I don't know how they've done it, but they've won three races in a row without the best car in any of the races. Is that just plain execution?
Execution, but, you know, he's sitting around running top five all day, and nobody's really talking about him. And next thing you know, he's in victory lane. But watching that group, that entire group at Penske, just do what they do all year long. No one talked about them. No one talked about them. And all of a sudden, here they are, playoffs, and they're running well. Each and every one of them, from Ryan Blaney, you know, all of the cars are running well.
I don't think they could have picked three better races to win two crown jewels in the first race in the playoffs. So they advanced to round two automatically because of that. All right, when everyone looked at round one, they all said, okay, the road course at Charlotte's going to be a wild card. Oh, wait, there's a short track at Richmond. That's going to be a wild card. Nobody predicted Vegas to be the wild card it was. Were you surprised so many playoff drivers had issues?
Well, no one thought it would be 105 degrees out there either. So I was surprised at how the race played out towards the end and throughout the entire race. All the guys that had the trouble. And what really surprised me is how much trouble Gibbs had. They were not that good. I mean, I thought that the 20 car was okay setting on the pole, but they didn't run that well. The 18 come out with an okay finish, but he spun out on his own. The 11 car spun out on his own. So that's what surprised me more than anything.
And add to that, Eric Jones' issues as well. All right, let's take a look at the playoff grid as we head to race number two of round one. And you see Kevin Harvick, who had issues. Thankfully, he has those 50 bonus points. But below the cut line, Chris, I want to pay attention to Chase Elliott, Jimmy Johnson, Eric Jones, and Denny Hamlin. Of those, who are you worried about the most?
Jimmy Johnson. But let's say he ran well this weekend, but I'm still a little bit worried about that group. You know, Chase Elliott has seemed to have speed at Richmond, but Jimmy Johnson hadn't had speed at Richmond in a while. And then you come into the road course at Charlotte, so I don't know. Jimmy Johnson is worrying me the most, but listen, like they said, don't poke the bear because he will wake up and he'll get you.
Well, he's a seven-time champ for a reason,
he is a
right?
seven-time champ.
You know, I'm curious, the team mindset. Is there a sense that, hey, you've got to gain points this Saturday night because you never know what's going to happen at the road course at Charlotte next week?
I think that's every week. You know, I listened to Austin Dillon a lot this weekend, starting from the rear of the field, and they thought the same thing. We got to gain all the points we can gain at Las Vegas because we never know what's going to happen at Richmond. Now you go into Richmond above the cut line and you're just trying to maintain. So I think the guys at the back, they're thinking, oh, we got to gain all the points we can going into the road course. But those big three that we have been calling the big three, now throwing Keselowski in there, I don't feel they're sitting there doing that. I think they're just trying to get their cars better and better and better for the next round to get ready for Homestead.
All right, Chris, Richmond this weekend. It's a racetrack to me that sometimes drivers hit it and they'll lead 250 laps and the next time they come back, they lead no lap. So why is it a racetrack of kind of haves and have-nots?
That's a great question because I feel like when we get to Richmond in the spring, the race car is just like really, really tight and into the racetrack. When we come back in the fall, you're super loose. It's got to be the summertime that the racetrack takes on, the sunshine, the temperature, and everything else that goes on at Richmond. But, man, it's a tough racetrack to get a hold to in the fall versus the springtime.
All right, time for our NASCAR Fantasy Live picks. Who are you going to go with this week at Richmond?
Well, you know what? We always talk about the big three, and we always pick the big three. I'm not picking a big three this weekend. I am picking Joey Logano in the 22 car. I feel like he's going to get a little bit of revenge from a couple years ago or last year when he ran so well there. So I feel like Joey Logano goes out, dominates this weekend, and puts Penske in victory lane for four times in a row.
I'm going to go with Denny Hamlin this weekend. They tested at Richmond a couple of weeks ago. And I think Richmond is one of those racetracks where you can hit it. I think Denny Hamlin and his team very strong there. Kyle Larson was also very good at that Richmond test. He's tempting to pick, but I'm going to go with Denny Hamlin.
He is, but Denny Hamlin is a hometown favorite, so he's going to have a lot of crowd on his back.
All right, it's the Federated Auto Parts 400, 7:30 Eastern, Saturday night on NBCSN. Make sure you check it out.